This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at CR College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to use differential analysis to determine whether to make or to buy a product. That is, we're a company that manufactures a product and we're trying to figure out, do we manufacture that internally? This is the first bullet point. Or do we go to the outside and buy the product? And by the way, when we say go to the outside to buy a product, that is often called outsourcing. That's the common term. Differential analysis can be used to analyze make-or-buy decisions, and we're going to talk about how to do that in this video. So how is differential analysis used for make-or-buy decisions? First of all, we have to figure out the costs that are associated with making the product internally, doing it on our own, basically, and we're going to call that alternative one. And we also have to look at the costs associated with buying the product from another source, that is, outsourcing the product. And then, as you'll see this in the second bullet point here, we have to figure out the differential amounts between each of those two alternatives. And from there, in the third bullet point here, we want to choose the alternative that has the lowest cost. Now, there are other factors to consider aside from just the dollar amounts, and that's a separate lecture that I've posted having to do with qualitative factors to consider. But here we're going to take a look at the format that is typically used to make this type of a decision with the dollar amounts that are associated with it. Here's the typical format that's used for a make or buy differential analysis. And the company that I'm using here is called Best Boards, Inc. And they make wakeboards. These are the boards that people will ride on and be towed by boats. So they're called wakeboards. And the company's called Best Boards, Inc. The decision that is facing us as Best Boards, Inc. is whether to make our wakeboards internally, and you're going to see the costs associated with that in this first column, or to outsource the production of our wakeboards, and you'll see that alternative in the second column. And then, of course, we'll look at the difference between those two alternatives and determine our best approach from the company's perspective. So in the first alternative, you'll notice these are all costs because we're just looking at the cost associated with either making the product or outsourcing the product. So everything you see here relates to the costs for each of these alternatives. And you'll notice that if we make the wakeboards internally, the variable costs that we're going to incur will be, of course, for direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead. And the fixed costs that we expect to incur are related to the lease on our factory equipment, that is, any monthly amounts that we have to pay for the equipment, the lease for the building, any rent that we have to pay on the building, and our production supervisor's salaries. So those fixed costs are spelled out here. And therefore, you'll notice our total costs, if we make our wakeboards internally, will be $1.1 million. Then we go to the outside and talk to an outside supplier, or maybe it's multiple outside suppliers, and find out what the cost would be if they made the wakeboards for us. And what you'll see here in the second column is all of our costs related to direct materials, direct labor, and variable manufacturing overhead go away if we outsource production. But of course, we're going to have variable costs going to somebody on the outside. They're going to charge us a certain amount per wakeboard, and that'll be our variable cost. We also are going to continue to have the factory equipment lease, and that implies that it's not easy to get out of that lease in the short term anyway. And we also are going to have, if we outsource, we'll continue to have rent that we have to pay on the factory building. In other words, we're not going to be able to get out of that lease quickly either. It looks like, I didn't give you the details here to support this number, so I'll just clarify it here. It looks like, though, that we'll be able to reduce our supervisor salaries by $50,000 if we do outsource. And therefore, our total costs will be $1,190,000 if we outsource this production. If you look at the differential column then, you'll see, and we can start with the total, that it's going to cost $90,000 more if we choose to outsource. The reason it's a negative number is the $90,000 is really looking at the making these products internally versus outsourcing these products, and it will be $90,000 less to make these products internally. As a result, our preferred course of action is to continue, assuming we're already doing this, is to continue to produce these wakeboards internally in our own facility. The next slide is going to show a summary version of this analysis. So take note of all the information that you see here in this column, this differential column. That information is going to be summarized in the next slide. So you can go back and forth between the two if you want to see where that information comes from. Some managers prefer not to see all the detail that you saw on the previous slide. Instead, they perhaps just want to see a summary of the differences from either producing these products internally, our wakeboards, or having somebody else do it for us, outsourcing that production. So that's what you see here in this analysis. This is just simply summarizing the difference between producing our wakeboards internally and outsourcing production. Right? That's what we're summarizing here. So again, go back to the previous slide and you'll see where these numbers right here come from. And so to give you an idea of what we have here, we're simply looking at what will happen if we outsource. Well, we know that the costs will increase if we buy from the outside, but we'll have some savings if in direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead, variable manufacturing overhead, if we outsource. And we'll also have some cost savings associated with supervisor salaries. However, when you net all of this out, it turns out that we will have a cost increase if we choose to outsource. And that's why the decision was to go ahead and continue to produce internally. I have one last piece of clarification here. When you see a number in parentheses, that implies that the result of that line item is a reduction in profit. And when you see numbers that are positive, that implies that those line items actually result in an increase in profit. So the bottom line here, the fact that that's negative means that if we outsource, our profit will go down by $90,000. So here are some key points associated with differential analysis. First of all, first bullet point here, differential analysis requires that we identify all revenues and costs that differ from one alternative to another, from one course of action to another. In the previous example, we were only looking at costs, but if it were a different type of an example where revenues were involved, for example, we're thinking about getting rid of a product line or perhaps getting dropping an unprofitable customer, then both revenues and costs would be affected, and we have to identify both the differential revenues and differential costs. Managers, second bullet point here, managers typically select the alternative that has the highest profit. And again, if we're only looking at differential analysis related to a make or buy scenario where we're focusing on costs, then the decision maker is typically going to select the alternative that has the lowest cost.